my interest is to understand how the external world is represented in the brain and how this representation is then processed into simple behavior. So not only we study simple innate behaviors, but we also studied in a relatively simple animal such as the fruit fly. The first part of our research, and this was a couple of years ago, was to figure out what happens at the periphery. How do the flies detect changes in temperature? And how are these changes in temperature relayed to the brain? Okay. So we discovered that the fly antenna contains thermoreceptor neurons. Neurons that respond to heating and neurons that respond to cooling. And we also discovered that they target a particular region of the brain, but they end up in two spots that are right next to each other. The activity of these two spots is somehow compared in order to figure out what to do about temperature. So the question is, how does this happen? So we essentially cataloged all the neurons that receive information from the hot and cold sensor at the periphery. Within the cell types that we discovered, there are also cells that only respond to either hot or cold, much like the neurons at the periphery. There is another class of neurons that responds almost equally well to both hot and cold. For a fruit fly, both heating and cooling from the ideal temperature is actually quite dangerous, and they want to get away from it. And in fact, when we silence these neurons, when we remove their activity, the flies lose the ability to avoid hot and cold. Interestingly, if we silence neurons that we discovered that only respond to cold temperature, the flies only lose their avoidance to cold temperatures, not their avoidance to hot. What we found makes a lot of sense, because the brain needs to break down information about the sensory stimulus. Some of the information you might want to have is the dynamics of a temperature change, when does it start, when does it stop, how hot or how cold it gets, and perhaps information about how dangerous it is. And we find that exactly population of cells that respond to these parameters. All this information then is broadcasted to different regions of the brain, but also converges to the same targets. It's like a putting together a rap song. So you have a synthesizer, each of which has a different tracks. One track might only have the beat, one track might have the melody. The cell types we discover are the different tracks, each of which is representing a particular feature of the stimulus. But there is also a region of the brain that receives all this information. So that's the only place where you can hear the whole song.